Hello everyone, this is the first one versus one. We are fortunately on the play. And this end is not keepable because... I mean, what could we do here? We can go... No, no, nothing, of course, nothing. So mulligan. I thought for a second that you can use mana from, like I say, diamond to cast... our card. Here I think that's a keep. Can't really look for something better. Soaring, I guess we put on the bottom since we are going to fetch anyways. I'm gonna grab a underground sea and cast a duress. Can also see casting Tatsis here in case opponent has like turn one mentor, stuff like that. But I prefer casting a duress first. And we're up against it's probably Oath of Druid. So here our opponent doesn't have black mana to cast Demonic Tutor. So if we discard Mystical Tutor and then we discard Demonic Tutor, it doesn't have nothing going on. So that's what I'm going to do. Discard Mystical Tutor and hope it doesn't draw a black source to cast a Demonic Tutor turn one. Okay, that's a drop. And that's a Mana Vault. We know all these cards. Alright, I don't have anything going on yet, so I'm just going to cast Tatsis. And, alright, he drew a Force of Will. Force of Will, it's an important card. Force of Will, as I said, it's an important card to look into because... we are combo deck, so maybe I might discard in this and hope it never draws the black source. So yeah, let's go this way, and we just wait until we draw. Yes, even a dark petition does it. Also, with this demonic tutor, it might tutor for what did he draw? That's a lot of mana. He drew Thinker. Alright. So Thinker, it's kinda doing it because we need to draw right now a payoff card. We have all this mana, but don't have a payoff card. I hope he doesn't play Darksteel Colossus. I hope he plays something like Inkwell Leviathan or the Sphinx. Oh, tutor for Black Lotus. Okay. So Demonic Tutor into... We know his end is a Grizzlebrand. Oh, the Demonic Tutor for Yogmoth's Will, most likely. And then he's going to recast Mana Vault and Thinker and Black Lotus. Yeah, that makes sense. Strictly better than just going for the Colossus. Meanwhile, the Tenders of Agony keep adding storm count on it. Oh, show and tell. Okay. Yeah, that's definitely better. Did not expect Grizzlebrand. All right, as things stands, we can just Tendrils aim for 8. Let's see. If he did not draw a cast spell, or just if he doesn't counter our ritual, we can Tendrils him. If he had tutor for the Darksteel Colossus, we probably would have won. But as things stands, we're trying to win anyway. I just have to hope all these ritual resolves. He did. Just another ritual. And I guess there's no risk to cast Dark Petition because he's just going to counter this Dark Petition. So I'm going to count to cast Tendrils on him. And even if he as a counterspell, it won't be good enough because this has four copies. So you can counter just one of these. All right. He needs two Force of Will. Oh no, he doesn't, because Force of Will let him lose one life. So I guess there's no out for him at this point. Three Force of Will. Yeah, with three Force of Will he can get out, but I don't think he doesn't even have all his blue card. All right, we won. Wow. Okay, so against Oat, what do I want? I want Annul. And I guess that's it. I'm gonna board out Urky Recall. And, I want all these defense grid and Totsies and etc. because he plays blue. Maybe it's just Wheel of Fortune. I'm not really in love with this card. But it's a payoff card. With Time Walk. I don't really like Time Walk in this deck. I mean, it's a power 9 card, you're going to play it and that's it, but overall, I'm okay with cutting it. So yeah, we go this way. Second game started, and this end, it's very, very interesting. With just one mana, we are about to play Yagmut Bargain. Or we just can go just for the wheel if we don't. It's risky, it's funny, I'll keep it. My opponent did not start with Forbidden Archer, which is a good thing. Oh no, Totsies is going to hurt us so much. Gonna discard Black Lotus. And their hand is falling apart. Guess we can always draw a land. Or just doesn't discard Black Lotus. But that's very, very strange. Mana Vault, so just since I F8, I didn't even get to press anything. All right, this is a Oat. It is okay, and I guess we're dead. But I mean, the last turn, he just barely killed himself, so might as well continue. What do I want to discard here? I guess I just gotta ponder. Okay, Grisbrand in play. What did he sideboard? Maybe a couple of Totsies. That's it. Also, if he plays Show and Tell for some reason, we have this Bargain that we can put into play. This time he did not attack. Sorry, did not draw 7 cards before doing anything else as he did in the previous game. Meanwhile, this Grizzlebrand put him on 23, which is going to let him draw the whole deck. I think now it's way more scared. I mean, doesn't even draw 7 more. Okay, we don't have Tendrils anymore, apparently. Sorry. Alright, drew 7. I mean, this game is obviously over. It's obviously over, but just. Just gonna see if he has some counters, if he shows us some sideboard card, can let us sideboard in a different way. Mainly, He boarded in, I think, Tatis and Duras, which are very powerful against us, since there is only one brainstorm in this format. It's maybe time for a show and tell. Omniscience. I don't know. No, Dictor time. Okay. Yeah, Dictor time is so powerful when you activate OAT because you can basically heal your whole deck. I mean, not all. So this deck doesn't play anymore the old Omniscience Emrakul plan. It's just a value OAT with. It's gonna just to fill his hand with powerful cards. Sorry, black. Okay. All right, Thunders of Agony. I didn't expect that. So concede. Is there against like a Storm Oath? I guess you can do anything, whatever you want when you have a Crystal Brand in play. Can board a Mind Rick Trap, but don't feel like if he has his old deck in hand, he's gonna find a way to counter, so to discard our main Mind Break. We can board out maybe a Defense Grid. I don't know what do I really want here. What does Ravenous Trap do? Yeah, wasn't worth it. I guess I can go this way. It's okay. On the play for this game. And what do we have here? We have a Library of Alexandria, which is usually enough to keep. Even though if our opponents start with the Totsies, it's very bad for us, but I guess I'm gonna keep this. Okay, library, go. Alright, no Totsies. Maybe. Just Volk. That's great. When your opponent has a slow start, it's a better way to have a Library of Alexandria also withdraw land. So that's ideal. Here. Since I drew a Dark Petition, I can start doing thing. I can go Ritual, 3. The Soaring, 4. Couple Therapy, 5. I can cast Dark Petition for Necro, but that's. That's too aggressive. I have this Soaring and this Defense Grid. I might just wait next turn where I can go Soaring Defense Grid. Or I can just do this turn. Yeah, let's do this. I'll just cast Soaring so that if he has a Mental Misstep, that's fine. And I'm going to go in Library next turn no matter what. But here I can take Badland, I think. There aren't that many blue cards in my deck, and I already have a red card in my hand. So, yeah. Let's go with Badland. And cast Soaring. Let's see. If he has a Mental Misstep for this, okay, sure, I'm gonna. Alright, if it doesn't, complete the Defense Grid here, and the next turn, win out safely. And just, I don't care anymore about the library because I already have everything in my hand. Let's see if he found the Force of Will with his Ancestral. He did, okay. Pitching Flusta Storm means it doesn't have any other blue cards in hand, probably. Since Flusta Storm is like one of the better. Necropotence. Okay, here I think I'm feeling safe in playing Dark Ritual. Duras. If you have a Mental Misstep again. Okay, it doesn't. So let's go ahead and Duras. Flusta Storm. Okay. 3 mana. I feel like I can pay 3 with Soaring and Library. And then I'll cast Kabar Ritual Necropotence. So, okay. Pay one. Yes. Okay. Yes. Okay. Pay one for so. Yes. And as there's probably going to resolve. Doesn't have anything relevant. I think I'm going to go after the Yawgmoth's Will because he has an ancestor in the graveyard. Just leaving him with nothing, barely. And I'm going to cast Kabar Ritual and Necropotence. Okay. Since I'm very high in life, I can just not lose that much, like 10, so that I have 2 turns. Or I can just lose a lot, like 15, and just win next turn no matter what. Yeah, let's go down to many cards. With 12, yeah. Going to 7, I don't know. I don't really know. 3, 6, 8, 9, 10, 11, and yeah, let's do this. 12, 12. Let's go with 12. And then discard. Sorry, and then, yeah, then say go and discard. Let me press F7. Yeah, it works. Our opponent fetched the end of turn to thin his deck. As they do. Okay, so what do we. Bear in mind that whatever you discard here is going to be exiled. I will discard for sure Yawgmoth's Bargain. A fetch land. What else? Wheel of Fortune. I can get rid of land, but in the eventual case he has a strip mine for bad land and don't have a black source to start with. So let's just keep the Underground Sea. Probably it's gonna be probes. I don't need probes. I have already plenty of spells to cast. I guess Ancestor is great, so I'm not gonna get rid of that. Maybe a Mox? So what's my plan next turn? I have 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 7 mana. I have to Duress first, and then I can Ritual Dark Petition. So yeah, maybe I can get rid of one Mox. Yeah. Let's get rid of these Mox. And last card. Last card might be just Vampiric Tutor. Yeah, I'll say. So I have 7 cards in hand and 1 draw for a turn. So I can Vampiric Tutor and cast and switch it with Library. And that's basically like 2 mana as a Dark Petition. Maybe 3, 5. I will be in the threshold, so Kabar Ritual and Dark Ritual are great. Maybe it's just this Ancestor Recall, as funny as it can be. Our opponent can't just cannot draw 1 card. If I'm not wrong, guess maybe I'm wrong and guess the green one cycled itself. I don't remember exactly. Probably it's gonna be Vamp or Dark Petition, but. I feel like I want to get rid of Vamp since it costs 2 life. Yeah. But no, that way if he draws like a Thoughtseize, it's gonna be bad. It's gonna probably be a Mox that I'm going to disc. It's funny as difficult as it is, since it's. Yeah, let's just get rid of Ancestral so that even if he top decks a discard spell. We have 2 ways to tutor for to tutor for what's it called? Yagmotswil. Can't have seven anymore, apparently. Yeah, could have also just discarded the underground sea and keep the ancestral and land, hope to draw a land off the three cards. Jeez. I just F6. Necropotence is apparently the most difficult card to work with on Magic Online. All right, his turn. We know he didn't have anything that scary, so probably just going to play Oath here. Let's see. This guy has Blessing. Oh no, yeah, it can't rip itself. It can't rip itself. Okay, so upkeep, nothing. Draw phase. Okay, so first thing I can do. Yeah, maybe we should have discarded that vamp. Since not really into just going for vamp right now. Because I can just vamp now, but then if you just let this resolve and counter the Dark Ritual, I mean, I guess I can start with yeah, I should have kept I should have kept the ancestor there, not the vamp. By the way, let's cast Duress. He did draw Mental Misstep. Okay. That's fine. I just have to hope he didn't draw as well, I guess, Flusterstorm Storm or Mind Break Trap. So let's just cast these Moxes. Dark Ritual. Now I'm in Threshold, so gonna cast Kaaba Ritual and then Dark Petition. Go get Yawgmoth's. First thing we do is casting Yawgmoth's Will. Okay, it resolved. So we are basically locked now. All right, and we won. Okay, so first 1 versus 1 is done. See you in the second one.